Level up, everybody!
Today's episode's about Monday morning cracks and going back to school.
And getting your education, because the more further you get educate yourself, the further we'll go in life.
It's also about computer programming languages.
Are you talking about the C++?
Yes.
So stay tuned and listen ahead to another episode of the Runner and Gunner Show. Hey, excuse me there, guys. Do you know if I could squeeze some tickets to the Hollywood Bowl?
Yeah.
Do you mean the Runner and Gunner show?
Yeah, man, that's what I'm talking about. It's a big thing going on tonight.
Well, what's up, man? I'm Gunner.
Yeah, and I'm Runner.
Baby. Sure, we could help you out. It's good meeting you, bro.
Just 2 free tickets. Here you go. Take them and go. Oh, really? Wow.
You're welcome, man. Here, has a bottle of champagne sent to you, too. See you later.
Thank you. Beverly, guess what? Star 69 me after this. We got 2 free passes to the Runner and Gunner show at the Hollywood Bowl tonight. All right.
Monday morning crack.
Cheers to everybody out there in the world, America, Germany, Japan, Spain, Brazil, all the continents, all the planets, all the galaxies. Cheers to everybody.
Cheers to everyone.
Everywhere.
Cheers to the world.
Yeah.
Cheers to traffic. If you're in traffic right
cheers
now.
Cheers to smog.
Go ahead, roll down the window and make friends with the person next to you.
Yeah, give them a high five and remember, don't drop 4 out of those 5 fingers and the one in the middle. Don't do that.
Don't do it.
You don't
want to
be the rude guy. You don't want to be Rudy Huxtable. So be very nice.
Unless you are Eminem and that is your job, that is your duty, your sworn duty. What is up, everybody? It is Monday. The morning show.
Good morning, everybody.
Monday, the morning 5th. Whatever day it is.
It's
Monday morning show. We are the Monday morning video game podcast. The Runner and Gunner video game podcast.
Runner and Gunner video game
podcast. Where we don't act like the Runner and Gunner video game podcast.
And we want everybody out there to guess what you could do to yourselves today? Level up. What does level up mean? Get that upgrade within your life. Wherever you need it, whatever you need to do, upgrade it. Level up, everybody. Get that mushroom, the green one, but don't take mushrooms, the magical ones, but take time to create a great way of life.
Totally legal. Totally legal, dude.
Yeah, they're actually legal to grow. So
they're actually legal to eat.
Yeah, sometimes.
Some people put it in their eggs in the morning. But I don't suggest it. Everybody out there,
some
stay sober.
Saute them.
We're taking a sip so that you don't have to.
With onions and steak.
It's Monday morning show. We talk about video games here. You know, if you haven't heard about us before, then go ahead and log on to your little clicking devices.
Clickety click.
And click on the little Instagram
clickety
icon.
Click.
And click on the little YouTube icon that's in our Instagram and start watching tons of great YouTube.
Great YouTube and great quality stuff.
Where we
that's
show
all we're going to do is
ladies.
Feed your minds with the ladies.
Huh? All right, everybody out there, we're here and we're going to talk about something serious.
Serious stuff, good stuff. But just remember, everybody, you are all Runner and Gunner. So no matter how great you think you are, no matter how awesome you think you are, you can only get better because you're never on top of the plateau.
To prove to Dad that I'm not a fool, I got my lunch packed up, my boots tied tight. I hope I don't get in a fight. Oh, back to school. Back to school.
You heard it correct, everybody.
And Adam Sandler's right.
The world is going back to school.
Everybody's going
to
back.
To prove to your fathers that you are no fool.
And your mothers that you will carry on the legacy of the father's last name or the mother's last name. Whatever name you took, you are going to improve. Whether you're a daughter, whether you're a son, whether you're adopted, whether you're fostered, whether you drink Fosters, whether you drink Corona. I mean, whether you want to learn or whether you want to be a dum-dum. You got to go back to school no matter what because it's the law, everybody.
But so what's your degrees in making video games? So what's your degrees in creating magical, mysterious video games for the world to play on their
mysterious.
Fingertips? So what? That your degree is in making devices that shine shards of light.
Make it shine, man.
Through
make
silicone and metals. And reflect and correspond to the buttons that we press. Who cares?
Who cares?
It's a good degree. And yeah. It's in demand and it makes money.
That's right. Just like the guys that make these rockets that they've been building instantly every day, and they blow them in the air, and then they fall down and leave debris into our lungs and make us inhale all this caca. But anyways, those guys that build those things that make all the caca breathe that you're inhaling in make tons of money, and it's all worth it.
That's right. And just like Rambo yields a machete, these people yield a keyboard.
And they do.
Mathematical skills.
That's what it is now. So the greatest thing now is to be mathematically correct. And it always has been to be mathematically wise. Yes. And just to be wise in your field of choice and your industry of where you feel like you could improve in and master in.
Yeah.
And so that's what we're telling everybody out there, to go get your education on. Because education is really cool when it comes down to it. If you want to get that money, go get that education.
What's that baseball player who won the World Series? Kirby?
The guy who eats all the characters in Nintendo?
Kirby the home run hitter for the Twins.
Oh, Bucket? Yeah.
Kirby Puckett.
Yeah, Kirby Puckett. Yeah, he's awesome.
Just like he hit home runs using mathematical skills. You should use mathematical skills
every day
to hit your home runs in whatever thing that you do.
Yeah, whatever makes you great, whatever you feel is great. And it might not be even... We're not talking about math completely, because it could be any other subject. Because what Gunner is saying also is mathematical skills can be also used in the field of language. Say you could speak 20 different languages, even four, even three different languages.
Three.
You could make so much
languages.
Money as a translator or
what about three different
non-hater.
Computer languages?
See, there we go again. Now you could speak Arabic computer, you could speak Chinese computer, you could speak English computer. If you could do all that,
what about
you could be a computer
languages.
Programming translator. See, what? So what we're saying is there's so many great fields out there, and there's so much opportunity in this great land that we'd like to call California. But not only that, this is the greatest country in the world. And I'm sorry, every other country. We love every other country, but we love the United States of America as well. And California, too. And we're telling you guys out there, they do give us free education still till this day.
What
and
about the language of
other people would die for it?
Pound symbol. Or the language of Java. Or the language of Go.
What about the language of love, everybody?
What about the language of love, everybody?
That's what everybody wants to really know, the language
that's
of
the
love.
The language of love. Runner, why don't you go ahead and tell everybody out there how to hold a lovely young lady's hand before the summer ends.
You grip it, you squeeze it, and then you... No, you don't do that. I'm just kidding. That's not how you do it, guys. Fellas, say you got your little summer love, your little fling, your little... You want to get your little ding-ding in the wing-wing... You know, flying away.
Ching ching.
Yeah, and then ching ching. But it's going to cost you some ching ching if you want to ding ding the wing wing. Anyways, if you guys know what I'm saying, if you want to fly into the high sky and the high and mighty land of the lover's lane, which we are driven to, most men are driven to, towards loving the girl. And we all love these girls equally, because everybody out there is looking for love. Ladies looking for love. Men looking for love. Who is not looking for love? The killer psycho killers, because they are looking to murder. Anyway,
Charles?
Yeah, the psychos. Anyways, besides them, the best way to get a girl to hold your hand is simply be yourself and also act really cool. Don't be nervous.
Super cool.
Don't be say any dumb comments, especially, and don't
like, oh, your shoes look stupid.
At her.
Your ponytail's dumb.
Parts too much. You could compliment.
Don't neck
anything.
Her.
Neck up, compliment. Neck down, don't compliment. Stay away from it until later on when you're holding her hand. Then you can say, "Oh, your hands are so soft."
Yeah.
And
these
what
these
kind of lotions do you use?
Are not the same ladies that
especially
the 90s
compliment
ladies
them,
were.
Especially on the smells and the scents and the way she appears, her appearances. Love the appearances. And you will get her hand in your grasp. And once you have that hand in your grasp, the rest is up to you. What direction do you want to go? Up
oh,
or
yeah.
down, right, left, you know.
A, B, A, B, square, X, triangle.
Yeah. X, W, Z, Y equals X,
all right, everybody.
O, X, O.
You heard it yourself. Just be yourself. Renner told you, and he's a master's degree in the language of love.
Language of love, everybody. Oh, that was a quick segment of the language of love.
Yeah, so, you know, listen up to the Renner and Gunner show every Monday morning where we Monday talk morning. About things like this. And don't worry, we will manage to make you embarrassed in front of your girlfriends by saying, the ladies.
The ladies.
But you got to say it like that, otherwise it embarrasses the no one watch. Like, the ladies.
Hey.
See, it doesn't work. But when you say, the ladies.
Hey.
Man, we're going to be talking about the ladies.
It gets some ding.
See, you know, you get a little embarrassed. This is the Runner and Gunner show. We're not psychologists, but we think like some. We act like
them. Yeah, we sure do.
Everybody out there,
if they're wearing a chastity belt, it would have been unlocked by now.
Well, then, put a ring on it. Look at everybody. We got a couple. We got a list of programming languages. All you designers listening to the Runner and Gunner
designers.
Show, video game podcast.
And we're not talking about clothing designers. We're talking about.
We're not talking about DK Donkey Kong. We're talking about programming designers. Yeah, you know, here's a list. All you game designers,
gamers,
developers, video game creators out there listening
all
to our show, because we are
go out there and get your chicks
video game podcast, and we are the Los Angeles podcast, and we are America's favorite podcast simply because we love America.
We love America
because that's where we're born.
That's and where we're born.
Everybody born all around the world should love where you're born.
Love it.
Everybody out there, some programming languages are Python. Or what about
R?
Or what about
R?
How about PHP?
PHP. Ruby.
How about Kelsey and Swift?
Swift.
SQL.
Perl.
Perl. The assembly language.
What about the Rust?
What about Kotlin?
Kotlin.
How about Scala?
Visual Basics.
ABAP.
Bash.
Bash is one of my favorites. You know why? Because you could say it like this. Bash.
CSS. Not CSI, CSS.
Yes, Bash the Invincible. Bash the Greatest.
Bash him.
Bash the Imploder.
Bash him.
Bash the Oracle.
Objective C.
Delphi.
Scratch.
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 You scratched my CD.
Don't scratch your booty.
Remember that from The Ringer? Well, anyways, everybody out there, we are here to tell you that those are some programming languages. But we got a special somebody who's talking about programming languages. Days of the past.
Way back.
Back when there was no programming languages and everything you created on the computer had to be handwritten on computer.
Yeah, the real days when you had to, like, actually labor to create your games or labor to create your whole concept of computerizing anything onto screen. And so,
could you imagine?
It's rough.
Some people can. Some people could imagine it.
It's hard to imagine, but it really existed. And it existed.
Unlike modern video games, most NES games were written by hand in assembly, and that's kind of insane. So assembly is just like one step above directly feeding binary instructions to a computer, and you use different assembly languages depending on the architecture. The Nintendo uses a modified version of a chip called the 6502, which was a very popular microprocessor from the late 70s, but it's pretty limited and doesn't even have a multiply instruction. Imagine working on Mario back in the day and having to write your own math library using only addition, subtraction, and loops before you could even begin on the game's logic.
Wow. That was so
can
much.
Can we hear
Gunner?
That again? Lennies out there, rewind that part of the show and listen to it again.
Did you hear the deepness within the it's actual facts though. It's not like he's just
assembly,
speaking
that was
out
on
of
the
his,
list too. Look at
yeah, he wasn't right just assembly speaking language. Out of his colon. He was speaking out of his mind and brain, and he was speaking actual facts that he dug up deep.
An assembly language is a type of low-level programming language that is intended to communicate directly with the computer's hardware.
Waka waka.
Communication with the computer's hardware is an assembly language. Low-level programming.
Keep it on the low-low.
Stupid. Dummies use this. No, just playing. It's an old 70s language. That I don't know. They used to use.
You know
back
what
in the
I gotta
day.
Tell you about that Gunner? Groovy. That's groovy.
Look
man.
What it looks like, Runner.
It sounds groovy.
Imagine that's how Mario is created.
Wow! Look at those chips. The chips look so different.
Like how
you know what it reminds me of? Chips. See, the show chips.
How does that like translate that? To colors in a little man running across bricks?
Well, he just explained it was insane. It was a lot of freaking brain work, and they used the old chips from the 70s to create games in the mid to late 80s, even the early 90s. they're still using that old chip from the 70s and creating it by hand. So this is equal to me, it's equal to like creating cartoons back in the day, like say Snoopy and Scooby-Doo and Looney Tunes, like by hand.
Maybe
hand
even Snow drawing. White.
And even, all right, I could go as far back as saying the Simpsons were first hand drawn.
Yeah.
Hand drawn as well. Just like the video game. So this is talking about, what he's saying is that the origination of video games were actually just like
hand drawn. They're hand drawn. Exactly.
And so that's why we wanted to break it down for the runner gunner maniacs out there. We wanted you maniacs to know that that's how video games really did start off. And they used the same hand drawn stuff as Atari, Pong, you know, as what else?
So Atari would be like Steamboat Willie, and NES would be like Snow White and Pinocchio.
Right.
Yeah. And then, you know, Toy Story would be like Nintendo 64, and Coco would be like PlayStation 5 and beyond and all that. And it's kind of going hand in hand if you really notice it. Like,
it is.
You really observe what's going on, but it's happening at a much faster rate, but now it kind of slowed down. Like, the programming for movies and CGI are kind of at the same level
say, Gunner, as the programming from video games. They got kind of lazy later on, like absolutely, as everything had progressed. Because
but we're not holding against these developers.
We're not. Because they do have much better...
Google the assembly language.
It takes a long time to create those graphics that high now. But is it more about the graphics, or is it more about
what
the game...
Tell them to Google this. Tell them to Google the assembly language.
Google the assembly language, everybody.
And why should they Google the assembly language?
Because it's going to show you how the original games were produced way back in from the 70s all the way up. It's going to build it all the way up. And it's a whole building block of how, you know, step by step, how they actually started and converted from hardware to mechanic language, assembly language, high level language, Java, C++, Pascal, OO, and Visual language. So that's what
he
happens.
Said something very interesting. He said that they only used plus and minus, adding and subtracting, like there was no multiplying.
Yes. So
makes me think, like, maybe Super NES was when they finally started to multiply, or was it Nintendo 64,
or maybe even Sega Genesis?
Or Sega Genesis would do it if Super Nintendo did it. Sega Genesis did because so they were the same.
We don't really know. Maybe PlayStation 1 did it. What if they were the ones? Because they came around right during
audience,
the time.
Audience, do you know?
Nintendo 64?
How do we even Google that? How do we even discover what was the first
plus
console that started multiplying?
Plus and minuses.
You know, zeros and ones are the numbers, mm-hmm. whatever you call them. The language, the hardware.
The language, yeah.
The assembly language.
So the mechanical language.
It just blows my mind. You know,
it's a whole block.
It's like not even math. I mean, it's not even art. It's math.
Yes.
It's not even art. This is not Super NES. Mario was not art. It was math. And did he say Super Mario only or just all of NES?
I think all of NES.
NES.
It covers all of NES.
So like, you know, like we look at it as art now, but it's not.
But they don't use the same formats anymore.
Geniuses. Adding things together.
That's the thing. That's what kind of trips us out, is that why don't they use it when they should? Because it could create a whole catastrophe of creativity. It could bring out, and the independent gamers, I kind of get it. You guys are trying to use it, and it's okay. And I see that it's out there. I could see it.
They're using
nothing big comes out.
Chunks of programming that's already developed by someone else.
Yes, not no original.
So they're pretty much moving colors across the screen.
And
whereas
it's simple.
Nintendo was creating the colors.
Creating the colors, the bricks that get broken, the coins that get hit by the heads,
the
feathers.
That allows you to run across bricks but not walk across bricks.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, gaps. Run across gaps,
fall
but not walk across
and lose
gaps.
Your life.
Like those kind of physics didn't exist in the 50s and the 40s on computers.
But the trippy thing is, it was out in the 70s, and somehow Nintendo, in the late and mid 80s, enhanced it so well that they brought out these old 70s, physics, and just created a whole dynasty.
Sonar to create Mario. Or I don't know, like. It really blows my mind to think about, like...
It's pretty cool. It's very cool, actually.
They're them using
amazing.
The assembly language to create the greatest game ever created.
And I will also credit Gunner for bringing it to my attention. he's the one who brought it up, and that was amazing. And I already knew. I didn't know, but I already knew what that things had changed within time. Just like you guys out there knew that video games have changed big time, and we knew that the creation wasn't the same, you know, back then the way it is now. Because the way it is now, it is lazily made, and you can see it. You can see how lazily made it is.
Somebody programmed it. Just like Unreal, like when you use the Unreal engine.
See,
like,
but there is a way somebody programmed the Unreal engine. Voice actors and to do both at the same time, there's a way to do it, and not doing it though.
Well,
they're
exactly.
Too lazy.
Again, the voice actors, somebody programmed the microphone and the computer to record these voice actors, but the video game developers did not create the language that made the voices and the movies in this game, the CGI cutscenes. They didn't create that language. They took a language that was already created and they designed a game off of someone else's language. So essentially, the same language is being used by everyone.
Yeah.
Everyone's
using the same video game language. They're trying to turn it into a universal language, but it really isn't.
But to create a really unique, authentic video game, you need to create your own language, just like Mario did.
Exactly.
But they used it off the assembly language, which is still technically...
But we could go as far as say that Sonic did create its own language as well. Because Sonic did create the speed, you know, the speed where they go ahead.
All right.
So they did kind of go ahead of that language. What they did, they had to do all that by hand as well.
So
it wasn't only Mario. Sonic the Hedgehog Part 1 did actually
use that
speed that was going ahead.
Mario,
so
NES,
they have their own language as well.
NES did create their language.
Well,
on
NES is
someone
the
else's language. They
did use the assembly. They used Atari and beyond
the
before Atari.
Language.
Yes, the assembly, which was Atari and beyond.
And beyond, yeah,
before.
70s, yep.
Yeah.
And so they
which
used...
Which they probably used in the government. We're going to go into that because we don't want to get in trouble. But they did use them in those big old giant computers that used to print out stuff. We're not going to talk about the CIA stuff. We're not going to talk about aliens or anything crazy. But they did use
Bigfoot.
Bigfoot.
Bigfoot's
and the Loch
family
Monster.
Tree.
And all of them.
Oh, yeah. So the assembly language,
Mama.
NES was built on the assembly language. They created their own library. And that's the key point, because that's what Runner and Gunner's doing. We're creating our own library using the Spotify or whatever we're uploading our
and
podcast
our own
on
creativity,
YouTube.
Which is origination. So
we're using YouTube's language, but
exactly.
It's Runner and Gunner's library, you know?
Exactly,
like
exactly.
The bigger picture.
We're using their platform for our own language. And we're creating our own language, which means we're building our own buildings, our own pyramids, our et cetera, you know?
Yeah, whatever you know?
You want to call it. But that's
our own folders,
that's what the
Runner and
Gunner files. Shana is.
You know, like we got skits. We got knowledge. We got video game trivia, video game facts. You know, in fact, we got shout-outs, too. This one was brought to you. Oh. Yes, we're doing that. We got to announce.
We're doing it. Sorry, all right,
we got to announce
go,
who
guys.
The video was brought to by. I showed it to Runner, but at NES Hacker on YouTube
That's
is
the
one who showed it to me.
That's the master.
And the title is NES Games Were Written in Assembly.
They were.
Hashtag Nintendo, hashtag NES. And they were. And that's what we're talking about. If you're just joining us mentally, if you spaced out for the last 15 minutes listening
then
to Gunner's
back.
Voice talk to you, saying sexy things to you, like listen to the Runner and Gunner show every Monday morning.
Monday morning cracks,
on
everybody.
Spotify and YouTube and anywhere you can listen to
that's
a podcast.
Right. Find your platform because your
that's
platform
right, everybody.
Is amazing.
Everybody out there, we gotta take a quick commercial break.
Yes, we do.
But before
but
we
after
go,
that,
we want to cheers y'all because we're having a sip for you on a Monday morning so that you don't have to.
Yeah. We're just helping you fight that traffic with our own sip. So cheers,
this
Gunner!
This is the Runner and Gunner show. We're telling you to vote Runner and Gunner. Just vote us as presidents. We'll
just vote the RNG.
Job.
We'll be on that ballot.
Also, we want to tell you that President Runner is also a great candidate. And maybe
he's doing
consider
it.
Consider him.
Yeah, he's going to come back. Don't worry. He will be here as the election gets closer.
Yeah.
President Runner is going to address some stuff. So you guys better be prepared and better listen up for those addresses. It's going to be amazing. Addresses
also,
to get in them dresses.
We're very happy about the NFL season starting. It's going to be starting pretty soon.
NFL!
And we're very excited to see where the Raiders go.
The Raiders!
Because we are the Los Angeles podcast.
The Los Angeles podcast.
And so
podcast.
We have to talk about the Raiders, even
of
though they're the Las Vegas Raiders now, but we still love the Raiders.
Raiders.
Everybody out there.
Orale.
Monday morning show to you, everybody. We got a shout out to our commercial sponsors. One of them is Hilton Hotels.
Hilton!
And the Double Tree by Hilton this week, because you can get double the love at Double Tree.
And half the price.
And half the price, then. Paris Hilton is not included.
Mention Runner and Gunner and you get half off on Paris Hilton's hotel. Not half off her tops, but half off her hotel.
Yeah, everybody. We had a good Monday morning. We just want to say that the show is ending, but we wish you luck on your week. We hope you have a great week. We hope you accomplish everything that you set your heart out to accomplish.
Sure. Wait, Gunner, We got to give props to our sponsors.
Oh, yeah.
We can't forget. We got a commercial first, and then we'll end the show. All right.
All right, everybody, we got a quick commercial break. You know, when we come back, we're going to be talking about...
We'll be right back. You know, we'll be here, and then we'll...
anything.
We'll video games. The greatest part of the show after this, but we got to go real quick.
That is pretty great, though,
and
right?
We will be right back
after these commercial breaks.
What's up, America? I'm Snoop Dogg, and I'm here at the Olympics.
Hey, Snoop Dogg, and it's great to have you here in the Paris Olympics 2024. But Michael Phelps has just won another gold medal in 2024 Paris Olympics. What do you think about that, Snoop Dogg?
I'm just wondering, Michael Phelps, what are you going to do now that you won that gold medal?
I'm going to Disneyland.
Welcome back, everybody. It's the Runner and Gunner Show.
What's up, everybody? All right, the Runner and Gunner Video Game Podcast, and we are...
Thank you for listening to our sponsors.
We are here, and our sponsors do a good job. Thanks to our sponsors out there.
We wish you a safe drive.
And we did like the Olympics, and yes, indeed, America did win the most gold once again. And in 2028, the Olympics are coming to Los Angeles. So get ready for that.
Have you eaten American McDonald's? Talk about power. You pedal. You run faster.
Yeah.
Even in the pool. But anyways, extra everybody out there, we got a question for you and for everybody.
Everybody out there, this is the trivia question.
The question goes like this, all you audience. Hold on. Let's stop the music. Right. Stop the music. Yep. Frankie.
Yep. Put on pause.
Dang, Frankie, what are you doing back there? Marky.
Turn down. Marky.
You guys. Stop it, Marky.
Damn it, Frankie.
Freaking Marky. Trying to tamper with the equipment while we're recording.
The question is... What
programming languages
were commonly used for games made back in the retro days?
The 80s. The 90s. And the early 2000s. So, what programming languages were commonly used?
Which ones?
In games made?
All right, this is a trivia question.
In the days of past, 80s, 90s,
Maniacs, you guys know the answers.
The Maniacs know the answers to
the
this.
The Maniacs already
what
got it.
What gaming languages were used commonly?
Commonly.
To make Sega Genesis,
daily basis.
Nintendo 64, PlayStation.
That's right.
Game Boy Advance.
Correct. What else? Keep going. There's more. What about PSP?
PSP, yep.
PSP.
Maybe Dreamcast?
A little bit. Well, for sure PS1. What else? Man.
C++ was also. Oh, wait. We got the answer.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, what the heck are we talking about?
Oh, you already gave it.
No, programming languages were commonly used in the 80s, 90s, and 2000s. Let me tell you, it was C.
C.
It was C and C++.
The answer is C. And it's C++.
Yep. Assembly language, as we watched and listened to on the show, was to make NES and beyond. In the 70s.
And beyond. Isn't that crazy that they use the old programming language still? Still. They probably still use it to this day, but they don't. Yeah. Nah, they probably don't. But
and then C came out.
They used to.
And then C++.
C++ kicked butt.
That is the answer. Those were the programming languages most commonly used.
I know for sure.
In the 80s, 90s, and 2000s.
A game that currently is running, everybody out there, Roblox. Roblox definitely uses C++.
It better.
Because it has to. I mean, look at the graphics of it. It's so plain and simple, and that's why people love that game. And Minecraft. Minecraft uses C++ also. Just because of the graphics and the way it's used, I'm not completely sure about this. Frankie, is it true what I'm saying?
Frankie says that Roblox games and the Roblox platform itself are primarily built and scripted using C++.
All right. So I guess they were correct on this one. Lucky suckers.
Yes, you were correct.
I was
Runner, getting, you okay, could just see with your eyes. You could just see with your eyes.
Yeah.
And I understand and what so Runner's
saying.
And so
that means if Roblox was, that means Minecraft was as well. And we already know N64, most all games. And yeah, there was a lot. I mean, C++ has gone a long way. And we're talking about the beginning of time of video games.
Yeah.
We're talking about way back in the sculpture days.
Minecraft.
Of video games.
And Frankie's sending me the information right now.
All
right.
Let me know what he says, Gunner.
Minecraft uses C++.
Yes, indeed.
In some of its versions.
Of course it does. It has to.
That is amazing.
I mean, of course they upgrade all the time, but of course when they were like beta or, you know, when they were first coming out way back in, I don't know, when they came out way back in like 09 or 010 or Otani, whenever they came out those days, they were using C++. And we all know that's true. So everybody out there, that was the quiz of the day. And how far back does C++ go? Man, to retro days. So now, all our maniacs, they already knew this, but to our new Runner Gunner video game podcast audience, you guys know
hold
that
on, get another, getting another something from Marky.
Oh, what do you got? What do you got, Gunner?
Marky just sent me that. Ooh. Cyberpunk 2077 is written in Red Engine 4, which is based on C++.
Based. So that's
Cyberpunk.
Which is a big, giant game, and that's cool.
That's kind of cool.
But based means
but it based, like,
that's different.
Maybe their own libraries on C++. Maybe they, like kind of like NES. Mario used assembly.
Yeah.
Programming language to make its libraries.
It could have been certain effects. It means certain effects were used by the C++ graphics.
Mm.
It doesn't mean the full-on game and most probably little parts and pieces of the game that you could probably pick out. But
probably pick out,
pick out. There's little
with
certain
eyes,
parts.
You know,
that
you can do with your eyes,
and you can see it. You can see it. It's there, and just like Metal Gear Solid, and just stuff like that, you know, the founding fathers of games like that.
Very interesting world, this programming language
C++.
Stuff and people building on old programming language, people building their own programming language in which to build their game.
Yeah.
It's very strange. Runner and Gunner, we understand it, but I can understand how other people
might have a hard time
to
unravel the whole mystery of it all.
Can't even blink an eye to it. You
know? It's a mystery. It really is a mystery. I mean, you got to be really technical and you got to go. That's why we were talking about earlier. It brings us back to earlier.
Oh, you know.
Go to school, complete school.
Zero
and
ones,
guess what?
Flashing lights.
If you really want to learn about it
whatever.
All. Because Runner Gunner don't know about it all. We know the basics about it, which is cool. But if you really want to know about it, finish up your school, go to college. And get down with it,
yes,
just
please.
Like we told
get
you guys.
Get back to school. Go back to school, everybody.
But
summer
is
break
on.
Is over. Summer's almost over. It was a great summer. Summer 2024. Wasn't it so chill? It was so easy. You know, all the bad things. Whew. Luckily, we avoided.
Yeah.
You know, all the good things suddenly appeared in our life. Especially at the end of the summer, things are really looking good.
And you
it's
know what
hot,
I noticed,
everybody.
Gunner? This summer...
It's
the ground
hot.
Was shaking a lot.
Yeah, it was so hot the ground
and
was
I'm
shaking.
I'm not talking about lovemaking. I'm talking about the world, Mother Nature shaking that thing. Mother Nature was shaking her booty under the ground,
yeah,
and she was making a rockin' throughout the Southern California
it was
region.
Hot. It was very
and
hot.
We know
earthquake weather
that it was going down, and so California keep on shaking. You know that's what we're saying, shaking and baking.
Yep, so hopefully you leveled up just like the Runner and Gunner, so level up.
Level up.
Always listen to the Runner and Gunner show. We're here for you. We're going to get into the two-minute rundown right now. We're going to end the show and send you off in a merry little way all the way across to your destination.
Woo.
Everybody out there, yes, it is so hot that
hot.
People are having a good time. Because it's so hot you can't do anything but have a good time.
Yeah.
That's all
that's
there
all
is
you
to
can
it.
Do. That's all you can do. And just stay cool out there. You
stay
know?
Cool, everybody.
Blast your air conditioners. Blast your fans, you know. Just... have a good time, though. Wherever you are, just know that this heat isn't going to last forever. We got about one more month left
enjoy
of it.
Enjoy it. It feels
so
good.
Enjoy it while it's here. It
I
is.
Like it. It feels
you know,
really good.
You know, it's vitamin K for you. It's a vitamin. And,
it's a vitamin.
And it's natural. It's natural herbs for your...
Get out there. Jump in the lakes. Jump in the pool.
Do it, ladies.
Drink
and men.
Some ice cold lemonade. get sweaty, get dirty, you know? Take a cold shower.
Sure. That's for sure, everybody out there. So we want you guys, we're going to let you go on your merry on ways. But before we let you go, we didn't forget about the greatest part of the show.
The greatest part of the show?
The best part of the show.
The best part of the show.
That we
love to call
the... Otani is still the leader in MLB. Of course, he's kicking butt, and Aaron Judge is right ahead of him, barely in home runs, but Otani has a better average. So, Otani, for MVP, everybody, just know that the Dodgers are in first place. The New York Yankees are in first place. It's going to be a New York Yankees and Los Angeles Dodgers World Series.
Don't forget the Astros.
What about NFL returning the Raiders? Are coming back to freaking revenge, everybody. We got Davante Adams. We got Aiden O'Connell. We got the backup quarterbacks going head-to-head against each other. So we'll see who will be the starting quarterback this year. It's going to be insane. But what's going on in the world of video games? Gunner!
Well, let me tell you, there's a lot going on in the world of video games because, first of all, video games are on strike, and they have been on strike since last month. Let me tell everybody, the strike is pending. All video games are put on hold. Everything you love about video games is not being created in the year that it should be created. But don't worry, that leap in technology is coming. C++, as we just heard, everybody. Who knows what they're making video games on programming languages right now? Because they could be making them on anything. They could be developing their own programming languages with these BTC geniuses. You know, they got all the money in the world. So we'll see what's happening. But definitely one thing is happening, that video game actors will not be prevalent in video games for the next coming year or two. And that's a good thing for Runner and Gunner and myself.
That's great.
But it's a bad thing for anybody who wants to play a brand new video game because it might be a while before we get one.
Whoa. Hey, Gunner, what about that auction I heard about where the video game is going off? Isn't it a Mario original? Can you tell us more about that?
Yes, that is correct. There is a Mario 1985 original unsealed, the true first copy of Mario SNES, going on sale in the auction in Dallas. There is an auction, a vintage video game auction, and Zelda,
about
Metroid,
4.
Controllers
million
from Days
dollars.
Of Past are going to be there. A lot is happening in the Dallas auction. We're going to see
so
what's going to happen.
Insane.
The prices are, you know, not really established yet, but I think $2 million for Mario.
And we want to thank
copy.
The United States
there,
for all of the Olympic medals that they brought home to us this year. Thank you, United States, for kicking butt in the Summer Olympics. Yes, we got the most medals. USA, USA. So, yeah, we are number one, and that's how it goes in the Runner and Gunner Show.
Yeah, but really, truly out there, everybody, what do you think Mario True First Copy is going to sell in the Dallas elections?
Auction.
Next week it's going to happen. So before you tell us, why don't you go on our YouTube and, you know, mention us, like us, and subscribe to us. And tell your friends about us because we're the new stuff going down.
Let us know how much you would bid on that thing. Because it
how much
first,
would you bid on it if you had
it
all the money in the
some
world?
Some kind of original copy or what makes this copy so different, yeah, Gunner, yeah.
Runner, if you had all the money in the
people
world.
People want to get it.
How much would you bid on this first ever copy of NES Mario?
150,000
pennies. 150,000
pennies?
That's like 150 bucks.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah. Well, okay. You heard it first, everybody. Also out there, everybody, Borderlands, the video game movie, flops. It's in our truest belief here at the Runner and Gunner Show that Kevin Hart should have played the Psycho and the Jason
Psycho
mask.
Psycho guy and Jack Black.
Jack Black.
Should have played
the fat guy with the gun.
With the freaking bazooka Joe.
And Bunny Girl Ear could have still been in it.
Yeah. And she could have been hopping around.
And why is Kane playing the Jason in the Psycho and a Jason mask? Why is Kane in this movie? There's
Kane.
You might as well have had The Undertaker play him. Not Kane.
That would have been cool. That would actually be in a better movie, actually. Yeah, if The Undertaker would have came out and just, you know, laid everybody down, did tombstones on everybody, and just and then just laid everybody down, that would have been so cool. I would have loved that movie so much.
Oh, and then you could have had a cameo with Hulk Hogan.
Yeah.
And been like having his American flag and been like, America, brother, let me help you out. And then America could have helped Borderlands. And then, you know, you didn't have to show America
and
winning.
And then play a little Derringer in the background.
Like, you know that they already win on their own, but the game's about like a post-apocalyptic world and, you know, like just the Americans come to help them. You know, that'd be cool. I think so.
Crazy times, great times. So, everybody, we got to go. We got to let you guys have a good old Monday and have a beautiful Monday. And we want you guys to know that we had a great time introducing all these crazy facts to you, all our maniacs out there.
It's a very technical episode.
We just wanted you guys to know that we just enjoy this. This is what we do, and this is how we do it. The same way as the geniuses, the same way as the greatnesses, the same way as the Beatles and all the great...
The same way as...
people have ever
done. NES and Mario did on the
back
assembly
in,
language.
That's right. We take it back to C++, and we are C++ plus A++ plus GNR plus us.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. All right, everybody. We got the party going for you so that you don't have to. You can focus on your job, focus on your reading,
and we want
focus
you
on your
to
exercise.
Know that if you
can
have
a
great
Monday,
then
you
can
have
a great life.
Every Monday morning.
Now on YouTube.